sleeping, he just waits and he stares. Someone's always standing in the darkest corner of my room. He's tall and wears a suit of black, dressed like the perfect groom.
We'll be right back. I'm here. Behind you, look. Behind you.
Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of posy. Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of posy. Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of posy.
Thank you.
lonely.
Disease in you. I will cure you.
Fear is a story that is sure to scare the hell right out of you. A mom told her son never to go into the basement. She kept the door shut, and when he jiggled the doorknob, it was always locked from the inside. But he wanted to see what was making that noise. It sounded like a dog, but there was something peculiar about its whimpering late at night that made him feel uneasy when he heard it. He wanted to see it. Maybe they could play fetch. The young boy questioned why she didn't want him to see it. But in his young mind, Mommy knew best. A few years later, the now 12-year-old boy was growing up fast. And one day, early in the morning, as he walked past the basement door, he couldn't help himself but turn the doorknob. It opened, and he tiptoed down the stairs a bit, and he didn't see a puppy. And all of a sudden, his mom grabbed him by the back of his shirt and yanked him, pulling him back up the stairs. She began yelling at him, screaming, saying there would be great consequences for not listening. Mommy had never yelled at him like this before, and it made him sad, and he cried. Then Mommy told him, never, ever go into the basement again. And then she gave him breakfast, and that made him feel all so much better. So he didn't ask her why the boy in the basement was making noises like a puppy, or why he didn't have any hands or feet.
I'm so lonely.
I'm here. Behind you, look. Behind you.